Hey, what's up guys? It's Derek from the Baseball Channel coming at you again today with yet another video, and today we are doing a review on this Buckler Fame Pro Series glove. Now this is all premium Texas steer hide. The leather feels amazing. The lace is Tennessee steer hide, which is also pretty good. It's not the thickest, but it'll definitely do the job. I just love the look of this glove. The all burgundy with the blonde lace, I think, really pops. It's not a colorway that you see all the time on gloves, but I definitely think it's one we should see more of. I love maroon on gloves. I think it really just kind of has a rich, full tone. It patinas nicely. This is actually my first burgundy glove, but I really like the look of it, and I'm really kind of enjoying it. Now, a couple downsides with this glove. I don't think the thumb padding, kind of like where these straps come down at the end, that kind of rubs a little bit sometimes. Other than that, the shape, I think, is really just a personal preference thing. Personally, I like a glove that's a little bit smaller with a deeper pocket. This one is a little bit longer, wider, with a shallower pocket. Now, for the right player, that can be perfect. If you like a glove that has some reach so you can get to that maybe backhand or forehand in the hole, you want a little extra, get that line drive above you, but you don't want to sacrifice any speed on double play turns, this might be good for you. Now, personally, I like my glove a little bit smaller than this, but at 11.5, it could be a really good option for you. It plays a little bit closer to like a Mizuno glove. Doesn't really quite feel like most Wilsons or Rawlings. It doesn't quite even feel like an NP because it's so wide. Probably somewhere between a 31 pattern and an NP pattern from Rawlings. Wilson doesn't really have something that's similar to this, kind of the way it's wider. It's more of like a lot of the Asian countries that play baseball use a glove a little bit wider and shallower like this. Japan, Korea, for example. But it's kind of just personal preference. So if you like something with a really shallow pocket, but you still want some length, this can be a pattern that really works for you. Now, Buckler, before it was producing gloves for other companies, all the big names in America, Wilson, Louisville Slugger, Easton, a lot of big companies, and they decided to basically just start on their own. And they sent this out to me. They're not paying me to say anything good about the glove. You know, that would basically be an advertisement, and for the integrity of my channel, I am always honest on every glove that I review. But this one, I really do think the quality is there. The liner is really comfortable. It's sheepskin. In between the finger soles, they even have it there. And it's really, really nice on your hand. Again, I don't think the thumb stall is the most comfortable thing, but it definitely is still pretty good. All of the leather on this is great. It comes with a 60% player break-in, so it's pretty movable right when you get it. All you really need to do is establish the pocket, kind of get your break-in. And I think within a week or two, or even a week, a few days, everyday practice, you can definitely get this thing game ready. If you like your glove really floppy, maybe it would take longer. If you like it stiff, you could probably use it after 3 days of playing catch. So it's really, really player friendly. It doesn't take a lot of work to get it broken in. Now, I can't really speak on durability just because I haven't had this glove long enough, but everything seems great. The craftsmanship, the stitching, all of that is really done well. Basically, with this glove, I think the quality is great. The biggest thing is just the pattern. It's a pretty unique pattern. If you want a shallower pocket, it could be a good place for you to start. If you like something smaller, shallower, maybe not. I don't know how their outfield, pitching, catcher's mitts are, first base mitts. They have all of that. I'll have links down below. But my consensus right now is it's a pretty good budget option for someone looking for this kind of pattern. This one, the steer hide, is $250. If you want Kip, that's $180. Some companies, it's for Rawlings, it's the other way around, where Kip is the pro preferred and steer hide is the heart of the hide. It kind of varies. I'm not sure how the Kip feels. I've seen other people talk about it and they seem to like it. What I do know is the steer hide is awesome. It is great, great leather. The pattern is really just the one thing that isn't for everyone, but if it's for you, it can be a really, really good pick. This is very much unlike any other glove I've used. It was kind of a different sort of experience, and if that's good for you, then I recommend a Buckler baseball glove. All right guys, that is going to do it for this video. Please like, comment, subscribe, and play ball. This is the Baseball Channel.